Dear students, today I am going to discuss the easy tips to solve inheritance questions. And this is from section 2 and it carries full 4 mark weightage. Some important points what I want to suggest you that all of you know about the definition of inheritance. This is a process of deriving one class from another existing class and that class act as a base class. In the question, you will see there are four parts that carries 1 mark each. Here, no partial marking for this question, so don't write any extra or less member function or data members in the answer. Now, for this question, most of the time, class definition for classes and inherited classes are given. On that basis, you have to answer the question. Now I am going to discuss some of the tips or you can say rules to solve these answers. Rule number 1 is to identify the type of inheritance. See, these three pictures, they show that this is first one is a multi-level inheritance where there are more than one level of inheritance is depicted. Second is hierarchical inheritance where there is one base class. But more than one derived classes are there. In case of multiple inheritance, we have two base class, or you can say more than two base classes can be there, but there is only one single derived class, that is a case of multiple inheritance. Children, don't confuse between these two type of inheritance. Most of the time what we found that student they commit this mistake in confusion. And other type of inheritance are single and hybrid. Single where there is one base class and one derived, and in hybrid this is a mixture of any two inheritance types. Rule number 2 is mode of inheritance. The mode decides that which section will derive to the next class, derived class. And in case of private mode of inheritance, protected and public members, they become private member of the derived class. Hence, accessibility work accordingly to the access modes. Then, in case of protected and public section, they become protected members of the derived class. So, these members will not be accessible by the object, although they were in the public section of the base class, but they will not be accessible by the object of derived class. In case of public mode of inheritance, protected members, they become protected member of the derived class, and public members, they become public members of the derived class. So their visibility modes that remain same as that of the base class to the derived class. Private members, they are inherited, but they are not visible in the derived class. Hence, they are not accessible by their member functions of the derived class. Rule number 3 says that if in the question it is asked write members, it means you have to write both data member and member function. In case data member is asked, write down only variable names. In case member function is asked, write only member function. So in case of member function, if you are writing member data member names, you are going to get 0 for that. And in case of data member, if you are mentioning member function, you will get 0. So, in any case, if it is asked member and no data member is there, so write down data member none. Then accessibility by object. An object can access only public section of the class. So, whenever in the question it is asked, mention the members or data members accessed by object. So, you have to check only the public section of the class and the derived functions and their own functions. Then accessibility by member function. A member function can access all the three sections of the class, including public, private, and protected section. Rule number 6 says function overriding. You have heard about function overloading, but function overriding is a concept when there is a same name of a function with same parameter also in the base and derived both. So when it comes, it is derived in the, that function is derived from the base class and the derived class has same name. Then this is the case of function overriding. So to call the base class function, you have to mention base class name followed by the scope resolver operator and function name, and you can call it through object name dot base class name, or you, if you are calling it inside the derived class, so you need to only write base class name. And in the question, if both the member in the answer, you have to write both the member name, function names. So write down with the class name, the function name and the class name. Then finding size of object, although size of integer depends on the compiler and processor you are using, but basically for CBSE, you follow all these size of the data bytes. Find out data types, find out the size of the class, including private members also. Most of the time students, they don't count the private members, but you have to count the entire data members size of a class and then sum up all the classes which are involved in the inheritance. Rule number 8 says constructor and destructor. Constructor of base class executes first, then its derived class constructor, and destructors, they always executed in the reverse order. In case of multiple inheritance, the first, whatever class you are writing first, that constructor will be on, then second class, and then the derived class constructor will be executed. Now for the previous year question, this question paper from CBSE 2017, Delhi question paper. In this first question is, which type of inheritance out of the following: single level, multi-level, multiple inheritance. Now if you see the rule number 1, this is a case of multi-level inheritance, because class 2 is deriving from class 1 and 3 is deriving from class 2. So you can check out the figure I have shown for multi-level. Second is, write name of all the member functions and which are directly accessible from object T. Here rule number 3 and 4 are applied, and in this, for object, we see the 3 and we see the public section of class 3, that is the get 3 and show function of class 3, and get 2 and show function, which are derived to this class, are also accessible. See, 1 mark for writing all correct function names. If you are not writing correct function name, you will get 0. Statement number 2. To call function show of class 2 from the object T of class 3. So this, here I have mentioned this under rule number 6. What will be the order of execution of the constructor when object T is declared inside main? For this, you see rule number 8. That is 1, 2 and 3. This is the correct order of your constructor calling. You can write parentheses or you can avoid the parentheses. Both patterns are acceptable. If we see the question from CBSE 2016, here multiple inheritance is depicted because showroom class is derived from product and wholesaler class. Then we have write the name of all data members which are directly accessible from the member function of class showroom. Here rule number 3 and 5. Data members of class showroom are name, city, manager and quantity as the from the base class function, base class it's derived. Again I am mentioning there are no marks for any partial answer. You have to write these 4 to get the correct answer. In question number 3, write the name of all the member functions which are directly accessible by object of class showroom. Here from class public product, you can see get in and show function will be accessible, and from its own input and view will be accessible. The order of execution of constructor will remain the pattern same: base class, product, wholesaler and then showroom. Question from CBSE 2015. Here again multi-level inheritance is depicted. Then write the name of all the data members which are directly accessible from member function. Again rule 3 and 5, member function for class paint, and the code is wall area, color code and advance, and the type in the protected section, advance from the base class, will be accessible. In question number 3, name of all member functions which are directly accessible by an object of class bill. So again, we will follow the rule number 3 and 4 to answer. Billing and print from bill class, and pbook, pview from paint, and book and view from the class exterior. Order of constructor, again base class, constructor, exterior, paint, and then bill will be executed. For CBSE 2014, they have asked again which type of inheritance. Children, you see, this is the most important question. Rule number 1 says multi-level inheritance. The name of those member functions which are directly accessed from objects of applicant. Again, rule number 3 and 4. Then if you see the name of data members which can be accessed directly accessible from member function of class applicant, that is again, member function can access all the three sections. So registration number, name, and budget from the base class. It is derived to this class applicant. Now, to call the function display, as this is under private section of department, so it is not accessible by the class object of class department For 2013, same kind of question. Again, the type of inheritance multi-level, and name of data members from object of class report. Again, it's the overall grade. If we see the class report for object, it is overall grade, remarks. These two are under public section. Then name of those member functions which can be directly accessible from the object of class report. Now, object of class report, and if you see the public section, it is re-evaluate, rprint, sentry, display from the class score. Now, all the members of student are privately in the private section of class score, hence they will not further derived to the class report. Name of those data members which are directly accessible by sentry, function of class score. Now, sentry can access its own members plus derived members. So, marks, grade, and sname will be accessible. Children, now I am giving you one question to do. If you have understood this concept from my video, you write down the answer and write down the answer for this question, and you will find the answers to this question on my blog. So follow the link given in the description box to find out the answer. Thank you so much for viewing this video, and this video will be fruitful if you are implementing the tips given by me. Thank you so much. Press the bell icon for the notifications. Subscribe to the channel and share it for maximizing its benefit. Thank you so much.